cry when you said goodbye.
Why is it that everywhere I go to make these videos is incredibly slippery? Seaweed is like the ice of the water. Seaweed is like the ice of the water.
You're the one to blame. Oh, well, goodbye.
All right, let's get down to brass tacks. It's beautiful out. It feels like spring. I have a sprain in my step, and I'm ready to take you along as I find some interesting, potentially fun photos to take. Two, to be precise. We're at number 7, the GW690. Only gets 8 shots per 120 roll, so let's make it good. Also, let's talk about how Beethoven 2, the movie about that giant dog, the sequel, they did not make it good. Welcome to the show. This is Nuts and Gum. This is Last Shot of the Roll, episode 3. Today's episode, I'm coming at you not from the ocean, but from a river that flows into the ocean. It's very different. I believe it's called brackish water because it's salt water, or part of it's salt water. I think it's all salt water. There's a bunch of taffy. I think this is how they make taffy. Saltwater taffy. Anyway, do you guys know that if you didn't have the pogs that had the little furry mascot on them, those weren't real pogs. You had imposter milk caps.
Here comes now, mystery ship.
Okay, so I've been walking around in the seaweed beneath these docks that are put away for the winter. Sometimes this happens and you just can't find the inspiration, even though you're in a beautiful location and everyone that's watching thinks you're a real psychopath and you're disappointed in society for something or other. So you got to be careful not to just say, whoa, that light is amazing. If I take a photo, the photo is going to be amazing. Chances are you're going to fail. And then you'll be a failure. Which is never fun. Day two, we've returned back to a similar location that we were at yesterday, except I've moved up away from the dock area, the low tide docks area, and now I'm up here closer to the cottages and the woods, and we're gonna try our luck today, see if we can find anything worthy of the last shot of the roll. Sorry about that, boat. So let's see what we can get on film. On day two, sometimes you need a fresh pair of eyes and you gotta return to the scene to try to find that dream photo. Check it out. Here's a random fridge. It's a perfect spot for me to store my film in, and also a perfect spot for me to store my chicken quesadillas in. Ew. Yoo-hoo. Who drinks Yoo-hoo? Chocolate milk or nothing. Okay, so I think I found something. I'm ready to take my seventh shot of the roll. Behind me is this awesome garage that has this cool triangle light window thing, and it just is a cool color, and it has some cool light on it right now. So that's enough for me. So we're talking like 5'6" at a 250. Metering at the shadows, but I also need all these shadows to not drop. Highlights need to pop, shadows can't drop. Go somewhere in between metering. Okay, now that I can focus, let's do it. So The GW690 has a fixed lens that comes in somewhere around 30 millimeter, I think, maybe 35. So I'm gonna have to get way back. So unfortunately, there's this weird little outhouse looking thing, which is kind of ruining the shot from this angle. So on to the next angle. Finally, shot taken. Okay, so I actually had given up shooting the last shot of the roll today after I returned to the location that I was at yesterday, and I still couldn't find the inspiration to snap the photo. Until I was driving home dejected, as you would say, if you were describing someone that was driving home dejected. So there I was, driving home dejected, and what do I see? This seemingly mundane location has inspired me. It's surreal. There's this super full tree, tires, gas can, ice. It's perfect. 250. So the sun is actually moving. What I'm gonna do is try to move this stuff into the sun that's now shifted down. Oh, what an adventure. All great adventures end taking a photo of some tires in a field, and there just happens to be a gas container there. Remember that, folks. Also remember, Beethoven 2, not a good sequel.
To be together, you know what I mean. To be with you is something like a dream.